These are all the seeds we have from 4 jackfruit. Some were cooked, and then the green one was cooked, and then we had some ripe ones. But I'm just throwing them all in the Instant Pot, making sure they're all covered with water. I'm going to put some salt in there for flavor. It said 10 minutes, but I'm going to do 5 and just let them naturally release. I let it naturally release. The pin dropped. And more than 10 minutes. I just waited till I was ready. No rush. And now we'll take a look. And you can see some of the skins already came off on their own. So I just strained them all out here with a slotted spoon. Okay, most of them kind of come off really easy. You just peel right off. Those are nice. Some of them need a little help. So yeah, I like to use this little paring knife to help peel them off. I think it's better to do them when they're a little bit warm and still a little moist. Well, that took about an hour and a half. Most of them came off really easy, but there was a couple handfuls that were really hard to get off, so those took the longest. Maybe I'll do it next time for the whole 10 minutes or a little longer. We're ready to make our jackfruit seed hummus. I'm just going to use my favorite hummus recipe, and I'm replacing the garbanzo beans, the 2 15-ounce cans of garbanzo beans, with the same amount of the seeds. Instead of just water, I'm using a little beef broth. No lemon juice on this one. Those are the only changes. And then the same thing is the 3/4 cup of tahini, which is sesame seed paste, which is a key ingredient. And then we'll just add a little bit of smoked paprika, ground cumin, and a little salt if needed. I did put some salt in the seeds when I cooked them, but they weren't real salty, so we'll wait and see what it tastes like. You just beat it until, look at how creamy it is. And keep in mind, if it's, you want it a little soft, because when you refrigerate it, it's gonna get thicker. Tastes delicious. Mmm, oh, that's good. Here is the finished product. It's creamy. I did end up putting a little bit of olive oil in there too when I was mixing it. And then at the end, I top it with some olive oil and some, a little bit of extra spices, and refrigerate it for about an hour. You can have it on crackers or on bread. So I made almost two pounds worth of hummus, 2 batches, and these are almost a pound each, 4. So I got almost 6 pounds out of this.